Peach shows up good, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Are we ready?
Okay. I'm Professor Jean Geib, Director of the Apparel Technology and Research Center here at California State Polytechnic University, Pomona. Sitting with me is Charles Gilbert of Charles Gilbert Associates. And Charlie and I would like to give you a little bit of a preview about our class, Modular Manufacturing. And we're going to do that through a little bit of a conversation on a variety of topics. Thank you for joining us, Charlie.
My pleasure. Glad to be here.
I met Charlie in the spring of 1990, and guess how? I attended one of the classes he was doing on modular manufacturing, and since that time, Charlie's actually taught this class for us, at least a half a dozen times over the last several years. And we've always had a very curious group attending the class, some from smaller companies, some from larger companies, but I'd like Charlie to share how he, as a trained industrial engineer who had spent many, many hours working in traditional progressive bundle plant factories, what interested him about modular as a working professional, and what kind of spurred him on to do so much work in this area?
It was kind of interesting. I was attending a seminar or conference sponsored by the Apparel Research Committee of the American Apparel Manufacturers Association. And there was a guy on stage presenting a presentation on modular manufacturing concepts. His name was Bob Sticks of USU. And he was pounding his fist and walking up and down and ranting and raving like an evangelist preacher. I said, man, if this guy is that excited about this thing, I've got to find out more about it. So I called Bob after the conference was over, and I said, I'd like to come to your factory and see this concept. So he invited me to come up, and I went in to look at it, and I saw that it had some potential. But I also, based on his description, I thought it sounds like just an old line system, and that's what we were tearing out of the factories when I first came in this industry in 1965, so we could put in the bundle system. So I said, sounds like we're going backwards to me, but I went to see it, and I was somewhat impressed. And so I decided that I wanted to go to Japan, where they were practicing this on a wider basis to observe firsthand in apparel products and so forth, and reach my own conclusions. So I went to Japan and studied what they were doing and came back and decided that I was ready to give it a try and see if it would work. And so the first one I did was at Miller Dress in Kansas. And I told Ed Miller, I said, Ed, I think this will work for you, but you've got to understand, I've never done it. You're taking a chance. It's a real risk. And he said, well, let's give it a shot. And we did it, and we got like a 35% productivity gain. Just blew us both away. And from that point on, I became an evangelist preacher. So I started doing seminars and teaching other people how to do modules. And over the years, I've done lots of seminars all over the world. I've been as far as New Zealand to do seminars on modular manufacturing.
Mm-hmm. Now, you have 10 or 11 people in your firm, all from industry, I think mostly all industrial engineers who had the same background you had.
Exactly.
And would you talk about their conversion?
Well, being the president, they fell in line pretty quick. But no, all I had to do was show them, you know, the results we got, and they were believers right away. And I'll have to tell you, I talked about the modules at a conference, and I had a guy from Levi Strauss come to me and says, I've got to see this thing, you know. Mm-hmm. He was like I was, you got to show me. So I took him to Kansas to see this first module that set up. And he says, I wouldn't have believed it till I saw it, that you could get people to work at that kind of pace in a group environment.
Right.
And he says, we're going to do some work. Well, we did eventually, but it took some while. But anyway, he was like everybody else. You got to see it to believe it, and until you've seen it, it's very difficult to describe and to understand. But once you do see it, you will believe.
Well, I'd like to spend a minute talking about modular in relation to one of the often in print issues of supply chain management. I know there are a lot of people who spend a lot of time talking about this topic these days, and I think that modular has a real application when you say within a company, you know, we need to do some things to drive down costs, and we need to improve customer service, and we need to build relationships, And we need to reduce all that excess work in process inventory, finished goods inventory, et cetera. And so, you know, the terminology is that overarching belief that supply chain management can do something, and then somehow people separate that from what might actually be going on the production floor.
Sure.
Would you comment on that for just
sure.
a minute?
Yeah, the supply chain management is a total process, and so too many times people just look at the one aspect of getting it from the customer, not how it's being processed within the factory.
Right.
And so if you go, you know, behind the scenes, you got to look at how they're manufacturing the product. Right. And if they're doing the modular approach of some type, they can get it turned out quicker. They don't have to have the work in process. They don't have to have the all the materials tied up. And you can keep the materials till you actually have an order and then produce it, rather than trying to produce what you think to forecast what
right.
you think somebody's going to need, and you make mistakes and you end up with markdowns and whatever.
Right.
So it's just a way to improve the whole process. And if you
right.
can reduce that cycle time, squeeze it down from weeks and days to hours, then you're going to be a whole lot more accurate
right.
in what you produce and having the right thing ready when it's needed.
So modular is really a support. It's very much in line with the mentality associated with supply chain management, and it really does some very positive things to facilitate a company accomplishing its goals, even though most people think of it as possibly just a small piece that's only tied to the production floor, and in the bigger picture, you know, may not have the importance that some people might give to it.
That's correct. And as we'll see in the course, if you set up modules, you can actually calculate down to the minute almost when a product's going to come
right.
out and when you can deliver.
Right.
So you can, rather than say, we'll ship it by Friday, you can say, oh, I'll ship it by Wednesday at 2:30.
Right.
And know that you can be right. And,
right.
And that's the beauty of it.
Okay. Well, we hope you join us for our class. And the class has really been set up to provide you with the basic information to help you determine whether pursuing modules is a good choice for your company, what the issues are, what kinds of decisions you'll need to be making, and can hopefully help launch you towards a good decision about how modules might work in your company. So, thank you.